I'll tell you one issue where I know. I mean, I feel pretty confident of most of my positions, but I feel particularly confident in suggesting that we do have a problem as conservatives with media bias. It's real. And let me give you an example. Yesterday, as I think everybody knows, the House of Representatives voted to try to roll back the most obnoxious and offensive and inappropriate and destructive elements of Barack Obama's ill-considered executive order to issue work permits, which the president is not allowed to just create out of thin air, but to issue work permits to some 4 million people who are here right now without documentation or authorization. They're illegal. So the Wall Street Journal did what I think was an up-the-middle headline, and it's an accurate headline. The Wall Street Journal said in its headline, House votes to block immigration policy. Could anyone criticize that headline? No, that's the true statement that the House was making. It voted to block the immigration policy of President Obama. That has a picture of John Boehner. It says, John Boehner criticized executive action by President Obama. What does the New York Times say? Okay, hold on to your seat. Because it's so biased, and it's just wrong. Their front page headline, House votes to revoke immigrants' protections. Really? It doesn't say it's to change Obama's policy. House votes to revoke immigrants' protections, and then they continue the article inside, you know, the way they do. And then today, on page A16, they have this as the headline. House votes to revoke protection to Dreamers. In other words, it's not revoking a protection. It's affirming the constitutional authority of the House of Representatives and the Senate of the United States, as opposed to this wild and utterly irresponsible arrogation of power by the President of the United States. And this is just the beginning of the way that the left is going to distort this issue and demagogue it and use it. And honest to goodness, we better be out there calling them on it. By the way, the poll quote for the New York Times, the poll quote, it says, Republicans differ over legislation that has little chance of becoming law. Okay, the Republicans don't differ over the legislation. 240 Republicans voted for the core piece of legislation. 7 voted against it. That's not a big divide in the Republican Party.